Dear student, myself Dr. Kalichiran. Today in the chapter of antibiotic, we are going to discuss about the macrolide antibiotics. The various drugs we will discuss under these macrolide groups. The first drug under the macrolide group antibiotics are the erythromycin. Erythromycin is the first drug. It is used in 1950, and this drug is isolated from Streptomyces erythrus. And this erythromycin is alternative to penicillin group. As we know, the penicillin, P for penicillin and P for gram positive bacteria. Penicillin is very much active against the gram positive bacteria. In same manner, the erythromycin is also very much active against the gram-positive bacteria. And why it is alternative to penicillin? It is alternative to penicillin because penicillin causes various hypersensitivity reaction in some of the person. Thus, those person who are having highly sensitive with the penicillin, they are given erythromycin. And erythromycin in the earlier days, it was first drug in 1950 it was used, and then nowadays the erythromycin and its congener, that is the CAR, C for calithromycin, A for azithromycin, and R for roxithromycin. Thus, in this macrolide group antibiotic groups, we are having erythromycin and their congeners, calithromycin, azithromycin, and roxithromycin. Now we will discuss about the mechanism of action of these macrolide antibiotics. What is the mechanism of action? As we have discussed in earlier classes, that there is protein synthesis occur, and in this protein synthesis, this is the mRNA, this is the 30S ribosome, and this is the 50S ribosome. What happens, as we have discussed earlier, that when a newer antibiotic, when a newer amino acids get attached to the acceptor sites, and a chain, elongated chain is formed, and then elongated chain is formed on the acceptor sites, and then when the elongated chain is formed on the acceptor site, the translocation of elongated chain occurs to the P sites. What happens, these erythromycin and calithromycin groups, this translocation inhibits from acceptor site to the P site by binding to the 50S ribosome. Thus, erythromycin and calithromycin drugs binds with the 50S ribosome and inhibits the translocation of amino acid back from A site to the P site. As the translocation is inhibited, the elongation of amino acid is interrupted. Thus, we can say the ribosome not move along the mRNA to expose the codon, and which leads to premature termination. As this translocation is inhibited, the ribosome not moves along the mRNA, and thus there is premature termination occur and protein synthesis is inhibited. Thus, we can say the erythromycin or the calithromycin, it inhibits the protein synthesis. And when the protein synthesis is inhibited, the larger protein molecule synthesis is being suppressed. This is the mechanism of action of macrolide groups or the erythromycin. These erythromycin is bacteriostatic as well as bactericidal in nature. Bacteriostatic occur at the low dose, whereas cidal action occur at the high dose. And I initially told you that this erythromycin is very much active against the gram-positive bacteria and alternative to penicillin. Thus, it is highly active against, and this erythromycin is highly active on the gram positive bacteria and active multiplying bacteria, actively multiplying bacteria. Now the spectrum of spectrum of this erythromycin group. The antimicrobial spectrum of this group is the, it is mostly active over the gram positive bacteria. These erythromycin group drugs are very much active against the gram positive bacteria. And as a mnemonic, it is very, which type of bacteria it is active? DPL, DPL, D for diphtheria, Clostridium diphtheriae. And for pneumonia and pyogens, that is the Streptococcus pneumonia and Streptococcus pyogen, and L for Listeria, Neisseria listeria is the group. Thus this gram erythromycin drug is very much active against the DPL. Among the pharmacokinetics of erythromycin, in the pharmacokinetics, this is acid lavae. It means when the drug is taken orally, it reaches to the stomach, it will be broken down or it will be dissolved. So to protect or to dissolve the to protect the drug by destroying by from with the gastric acid, this drug is being intric coated. This drug is being intric coated. Intric coated means the drug, it is the drug, and drug is being enteric coated. Drug is being enteric coated. Thus, as the drug is being enteric coated, the gastric acid will not break down easily, not break down easily, and the drug is being released very slowly when it reaches to the duodenum. When the drug reaches to the duodenum, it is being released. In gastric acid, it is being prevented by enteric coated. The drug is being coated enteric, and thus gastric acid does not dissolve these drugs, and when the drug reaches to the duodenum, it is being absorbed. As soon as the drug is being absorbed, the high concentration is reached in the prostate. The erythromycin concentration is very much increased in prostate molecule. This drug is metabolized in the liver and excreted via the bile. The half-life of the erythromycin is the 1.5 hours. The drug is very widely distributed in the whole body tissue. This drug is very widely distributed in the whole body tissue. The dose of the erythromycin is the 250 mg to 500 mg 6 hourly. Drug interaction. This drug, erythromycin, is an enzyme inhibitor. Thus, enzyme inhibitors to say, whenever the other drug is taken, that metabolism being reduces. And thus, as soon as when the erythromycin, terfenadine and sisapride is taken with the erythromycin, it causes QT prolongation. Adverse effect of the erythromycin. Adverse effect of the erythromycin, it causes epigastric pain, hearing impairment, hepatitis, and hypersensitivity reaction. In hypersensitivity reaction, it causes rashes and fever. Uses of this drug. Where this drug is used, as we have discussed, that the erythromycin drug is used alternative to penicillin, and why alternative? Because those patients who is allergic to penicillin, they should take erythromycin. Thus, its uses occur in the Streptococcus pharyngitis. Streptococcus causing pharyngitis, tonsillitis, mastoiditis, community acquired pneumonia, H influenzae, and diphtheria. Against the diphtheria, erythromycin is very much active. Along with, it is also used against the tetanus, syphilis, gonorrhea, and leptospirosis. This erythromycin is the first drug of choice against the atypical pneumonia, whooping cough caused by the pertussis and synchroid. Thus, erythromycin is the first drug of choice against the atypical pneumonia, whooping cough and synchroids. Now the newer macrolides groups. Newer macrolides groups, it includes roxithromycin, calithromycin and azithromycin. I have discussed CAR, CAR. Then in roxithromycin, it is long acting and thus having plasma half-life is 12 hourly. That's why it is given BD, whereas erythromycin was given 6 hourly, and roxithromycin having good gastric tolerability, and this roxithromycin is highly effective in ENT problem such as in case of otitis media or tonsillitis, pharyngitis. It is also against used skin abscess, soft tissue and genital tract infection. Again, the drug we have got, it is the calithromycin. Calithromycin is also very much effective and newer drug, and it is effective against the MAC, that is the Mycobacterium avium complex. It is very much effective, as well as it is acid stable. It is acid stable, thus no coating is required, and it is rapidly absorbed. As this calithromycin is very much stable, acid stable, that's why it is given in the H. pylori infection, which causes peptic ulcer or the duodenal ulcers. Thus, this calithromycin is added in triple regimen in peptic ulcer drug. This calithromycin, why? Because this calithromycin is stable, acid stable, whereas we have discussed that erythromycin is acid labile, whereas calithromycin is acid stable. That's why it is included in the triple regimen to eradicate H. pylori infection. Calithromycin, when it is given, it eradicate H. pylori infection in within 2 weeks. Along with, it is also indicated in upper respiratory tract infection, lower respiratory tract infection, sinusitis and otitis media. Thus, calithromycin is very much useful, and nowadays it is commonly used against the H. pylori infection, patient having duodenal ulcer caused by this H. pylori bacteria, along with upper respiratory tract infection and lower respiratory tract infection. Now the drug is the azithromycin. Azithromycin drug is also very important drug, and it is very commonly used nowadays. Why it is commonly? It has got extended spectrum and having better tolerability. It has got extended in various antimicrobial is being on various mycobacterium having sidal action of this azithromycin. Thus, this is better tolerability as well as highly active than other macrolides groups. And this azithromycin drug is very commonly used. It is rapidly oral absorption occur, and larger volume of distribution is very large, and it is highly active, and it highly get concentrated in macrophages and fibroblast cells. It is entered into the macrophages and fibroblast and get concentrated. And plasma half-life is very long, about 50 or greater than 50 hour of the plasma half-life, because it has got very slow release, and it is excreted with the bile. Azithromycin having very slow release, and having, that's why the plasma half-life is greater than 50 hours, and it is excreted via bile. It is the first drug of choice against the legionaries, LCD. It is the first drug of choice against the LCD. L for legionaries pneumonia, C for chlamydia trachomatitis, chlamydia causes genital infection in female as well as in male. Thus, in this genital infection of the female or in the male, the azithromycin drug is the drug of choice. It is the drug of choice. Even a single 1 gram of azithromycin is very much active against the genital infection. Some female complain of whitish discharge, in this we use metronidazole along with azithromycin. Azithromycin in a single 1 gram of dose is very much effective and very much curative in the genital infection. D for donovanosis. Along with this 1 gram dose is also curative, also the drug of choice for chlamydia pneumonia. And the other usage of azithromycin, it is also commonly used against the pharyngitis, tonsillitis, sinusitis, otitis media and pneumonia. And very important, nowadays it is also used in the COVID-19 disease. It is also used in the COVID-19 disease and it is for the treatment of COVID-19 disease, azithromycin antibiotic is used. This azithromycin is in the regimen of COVID-19, this azithromycin is added. Along with, it is also used against the multi-drug resistant typhoid fever. If the typhoid fever persists and the patient gets resistant with the ceftriaxone or the cephalosporin group drugs, the azithromycin is very much effective against the multi-drug resistant typhoid fever. In pharyngitis or in the tonsillitis, it is used 500 milligram once daily. And it is to be taken before 1 hour of the food or 2 hours of the food, because food decreases its absorption, thus bioavailability will be decreases. That's why it should be taken 1 hour before the food or 2 hours after the food. This in the child, the dose of azithromycin is the 10 milligram per kg body weight per day for 3 days. Thus, this is the azithromycin and very much effective. It is used against and it is used this in COVID-19. The azithromycin is used in the regimen of COVID-19. So it is all about the macrolide antibiotic groups. Thank you.